Would you call it a crisis here in the European auto sector?
Well, yes, at the moment we do.
Yes, go ahead. Do you think
and
it's
do you
a crisis
see it getting worse?
In the European steel sector?
Well, I think the situation is relatively weak in the European sector for sure, and we definitely observe it through the whole of this year. But going forward, we expect that we could see recovery from that already in 2020.
We see some headlines from ArcelorMittal, of course, today. Very positive lines, beating estimates, the stock goes higher. Are you seeing any of these reasons to be optimistic?
We think it's also one of the signs that situation is not that bad in terms of the outlook going forward. We think the base is quite low and we could expect a moderate recovery from that.
Okay, and what about the U.S.-China trade wars? Tell me about how that affects your business in itself, but also how it affects the wider industry.
I think the question is more about the wider industry, because ourselves, we are not really directly impacted by that. But I think the overall sentiment and the overall trade, which we could improve as a result of positive outcome of that, will definitely help investments and will help steel demand.
Are you expecting, so you think that there'll be more investment in the steel industry if we see a resolution to the tensions around trade?
I think we definitely could expect a better situation in export-oriented economies like China, Germany, and I think generally in the US as well.
A lot of your product goes into the Russian economy, but some gets to Europe and to the car industry, as Matt was saying. Where do you see areas of weakness in demand?
Well, at the moment, of course, it's mostly Europe and partly Turkey, but it's more really related to automotive and machinery. Construction, which is a core part of our sales, is relatively resilient. So from that perspective, it's not that weak.
And which parts of the Russian economy concern you? Is there reason to be concerned there?
Well, I think overall we see that level of growth is not yet that strong. It's not going down, but growth is quite moderate. Going forward, I think we believe it has better potential. But at the moment, we see that situation is more like a relatively small growth, which we see across the industries.
Would consolidation in the Russian steel sector make sense?
Not at the moment. I think the Russian steel makers all are doing pretty good, and I don't see a lot of drivers which push them for.
Okay, and what about, you're holding a capital markets day, I understand, in London, which is why you're here. What's the message to investors?
I think the message is that we stick to our strategy and to our transformation, which we're doing at the moment. And despite of the fact that industry is quite volatile and we see significant pressure on some of the markets, we believe position of the company is very strong, and our CapEx program actually is focused to further improve our performance, both in downstream operations and our upstream.
Yeah, you announced at your last Capital Markets Day a plan to increase capital expenditure. Is that plan still in place?
Yes, it is. We still believe that we're in good position to continue. We see a lot of value in those projects. We see that we could afford it without putting company under risk in terms of strength of our balance sheet and profitability. So we think it's a good opportunity to develop company further.